I just saw this story. This is the worst idea ever. I'm trying to keep a straight face with this. Brett Favre would be intrigued by a Packers coaching offer.
Oh, no, that's on the Onion.
It's not on the Onion. It should be on the Onion. Can you imagine Aaron Rodgers waking up? That would be his personal hell. But let me tell you something, folks. Here's what coaching needs. Discipline, details, film study, adapting, and practice. Brett wasn't good at any of those. The two greatest players of my life who would make the two worst coaches are Charles Barkley and Brett Favre. They are two of the greatest players I've seen in my life. But Favre wasn't disciplined. He wasn't always coachable. He was incredibly stubborn. Schematics were second to ad-libbing. Film study was optional. And he was liked to practice as long as practice went short or went his way. Charles Barkley, similarly, a terrible practice player. Not really into the details. Sort of screwing off. Defense was optional. Schematics, same thing. Like, this is a terrible idea.
I disagree. I think it's a marvelous idea.
Well, it'd be a complete great story for us.
I root for chaos. This is a great idea. Packers, do it.
It would be 0-16 with Aaron Rodgers. They wouldn't win a single game. By the way, Brett Favre would hate coaching Brett Favre. Charles Barkley would hate coaching Charles Barkley. But there, by the way, Barkley's one of the 10, I've said it before, he's one of the 10 best basketball players I've ever seen. Barkley was unbelievable in his prime, and he's the best basketball broadcaster, analyst I've ever seen. He'd be a terrible. And if Charles is watching, I'm sure he's not, you'd be a terrible head coach. And if he ever says he'd be a good head coach, Shaq and Kenny Smith and Ernie Johnson need to stop and say, Chuck, you'd be a terrible head coach.
Well, Favre told us the TMZ Sports. He said, believe me, it's not going to happen, but how can you not be intrigued by that? Oh, this is the best story I've ever heard.